It's a beautiful morning.
I knew everyone in Clarion. Then the lipstick factory opened. Now I don't recognize a soul. I wonder where all those people went. Hello? I think maybe that teller's one of the Whitehead girls. Just grown up. I don't know her name. I used to call her Baby Whitehead, but I don't suppose they call her that anymore. Anyway, I won't be hanging around long enough to find out.
Have a nice day. Next, please.
He's got a gun!
Anybody move and I'll kill him. You hear me? Huh? Hey, keep your hands in the air. I'm warning you. I'll kill him. Hey, drop it. Don't even think about it. No, what are you doing?
Easy. Nice and easy.
Baby Whitehead?
Take the money.
What?
Take the money.
Thank you.
Keep calm, everybody. Just keep calm. Get out. You, keep your hands in the air. You're all doing real fine. Thank you very much. Stay back. Run. Run.
You're so young.
What?
I mean, I had this image of you in my mind, a bank robber. But you don't fit in. No, really, I can't go any further. My feet are killing me, and it turned out to be such a great day. I think I'm just
going
to walk
home. I'll tell you where you're going.
She drove off with the pump in the car. She can't drive anymore. That's the point. Just a second.
Yeah. When's the bus leave?
What bus?
The next one.
Oh, 5 minutes back. He's late as ever.
We're going to need 2 tickets to the end of the line.
Round trip?
One way.
$22.
Keep on behaving, ma'am. You're gonna be fine.
No, I can't. I can't get on this bus. I'm sorry. I didn't make arrangements for my kids after school.
Look, if it were up to me, we'd be 20 miles apart by now.
Isn't it up to you?
Come on.
Is it a good seat?
Shh.
Does it have to be so far?
Just keep going. What?
Nothing.
You take it easy, okay? I am serious. Don't try anything. Look, if they don't know who I am, I'm gonna let you go, all right? Just don't get panicky on me.
It's just that this is my very first time outside of Clarion.
What's your name, anyway?
Charlotte. What's yours?
I ain't telling you my name.
Well, I've got to call you something.
I ain't telling you my name.
Okay. How old are you?
I ain't telling you that either. See that? You're trying to trip me up. I know what you're doing.
No, I'm not gonna tell anybody if that's what you're thinking. The first thing you learn as a kid is not to squeal, right?
Yeah, right, right.
Well, if you're not even gonna try, I don't know how to talk to somebody that's so secretive.
Then shut up. Just shut up and let me think.
Well, it'd be easier for me to be quiet if you would take that shotgun out of my ribs.
Here, give me this.
Excuse me?
Just calm down. Lower your voice.
Pardon me?
What do you got in here? Any weapons?
Any... Well, of course not.
Well, it's not a weapon, huh? What? Turn around. You too, buddy.
What the heck is this thing?
Give me that. May I have it, please? Well, it's a... good luck thing. Can I have it?
Keep on trucking?
I got it ages ago in a cereal box, and this morning I came upon it again, and I was going to throw it out, and then, you know, I don't know how things go through your mind and everything. Well, I just thought, well, I looked at it, and I thought, well, maybe it's a sign that I shouldn't just sit there, that I should keep moving.
You took this as a sign?
Yeah. Well, a sign that I should leave my husband.
But hold on. You're leaving your husband now? Today?
No. That's why I was at the bank today, taking out my money.
Well, I'll be damned. Leaving your old man. I mean, I thought I was gonna get in the jam here. He's gonna have to stick the FBI on me. You're leaving him anyway.
Can I have it? Can I have it, please?
No. I think I'm gonna keep this. Metals have pins, and pins a deadly weapon.
That is a pin. It's an old, dull-pointed pin out of a cereal box. It doesn't have anything to do with...
I think of that poor woman. I could just cry. He's gonna kill her. I know it. Chop her up like a salad. Dispose of the body from coast to coast. Honestly, I could just cry.
So to speak?
Not yet. I don't want to be spotted.
Oh, what makes you think we're going to blend in better if we're the only people sitting on the bus?
I'm thinking, okay? Stop sighing. Crazy.
Okay. Look, don't burst a vein or anything, okay? But I have a little bit of a trouble with, you know, closed in spaces.
Yeah, so?
Well, so, if it's turned off its motor now, right? So it's become a closed-in space, and I really have to get off.
Look, you'll leave when I tell you.
I'm telling you, but I'm having hysterics in a minute. Oh!
All right, move it.
You know, I've never traveled anywhere. Have you? Hell, it's kind of a dirty town, isn't it? It's okay. Clarion is so clean. Oh, I smell French fries. God, I'm so hungry.
I'm warning you, lady. Shut up.
I'm chatty when I'm nervous. Shoot me.
People are staring.
Well, maybe it's the way you're holding your purse.
Whoa. Don't even think about it. Let's go. Come on.
I don't know how I feel about Chinese food. We don't have one in Clarion.
Quiet.
Oh. Oh, wow. Do you want anything else?
Come on, sit down.
What will you have? I'll have a hamburger, coffee, please. Do you have hamburgers here? Hey, Paul, in we look to hamburger.
Ah, you have some McDonald's.
Yeah, we have hamburgers. Okay.
I'll get a shot of tequila, two coffees, and burgers and fries. Turn around. How much you got?
You expect me to pay for this?
Yeah.
No.
Look, I would normally not ask a woman for money. Get traveling ain't cheap. You have to ask for your billfold.
Why don't you use the bank's money?
Because I only got $300. You think those puny bills are gonna last us the whole trip?
This is my personal money. Oh, all right. Here, I hope this satisfies you with this little bit of money I have, my own personal money.
Look, we'll call it a loan. I'll give it back to you.
Robert?
Earlier today, up in Clarion, the Clarion County Bank was held up by a lone gunman who took a hostage before escaping. We have actual footage of the bank robbery in progress. The suspect has been identified as Jake Sims Jr., a recent escapee from the Clarion County Jail. So far, no one has stepped forward to name the hostage. Heidi Anderson has the story.
I'm here with Walter A. Bailey, a security guard at the Clarion County Bank. What happened, Walter?
He just took out his gun and shot me, like I had a target pinned in my chest. Cold eyes, killer eyes, dead, like fish eyes.
So he shot you. Where did he shoot you?
In the bank.
No, I mean...
She never even saw him coming. Never stood a chance. She was very courageous.
Reporting live from Clarion County Bank, I'm Heidi Anderson.
In other news, at a small grade school in Loveland...
I never saw her room after I left it. It's so weird. No peanut table. Food allergies among children are... Were you really in prison?
Shh. I knew this would happen. They're looking for me by name.
I'm going to the ladies'
room. Sit down. It ain't me that's keeping you. It's them. There's one thing I can't stand. It's being locked up. I cannot stand.
Are you done slamming the table, or can I put these drinks down?
Thank you.
Thank you. They're gonna hunt me down. You're my protection until I get out of here, okay? Now just let me think. Let me just think.
I didn't say a thing. Jake. Sims Jr.
Take your pick.
Oh, I'm not doing it. What are you looking for?
I'm looking for one with keys inside.
Keys?
Yeah, to start the car.
Don't you know how to hotwire it?
Do you?
No.
We gotta keep looking. Bingo.
No. You don't mean it. An orange car? It's gonna stick out. Everybody's gonna notice it and remember it. It's not a... It's
stupid.
Get over there.
But it's a clown car.
Great. What kind of a moron locks the keys inside the car?
Oh, it's not even locked.
Get in.
This music's pretty loud, isn't it?
That's the way I like it, lady.
So, you earn a living robbing banks?
What I earn is my business. Fact is I'm a demolition fool.
Hmm?
I drive in demolition derbies.
Imagine.
Yeah. You got the wrong picture of me. Ain't none of this is my fault. Whole trouble is this. I'm a victim. Impulse. And I do what feels right at the time. Spend the rest of my life paying for it.
Like robbing banks?
No. Read it out loud.
Please come get me soon. It's like a prison here. Do you want your son to be born in a prison? Love, XXXX, Mindy. She a girl?
Yeah.
What is she in prison for?
She ain't in prison. She's a minor.
Oh, gosh, I could never be a minor. I'm claustrophobic.
I mean, she's 17. Jesus, baby.
Oh.
I mean, we've been going out for 4 years, off and on. She's in a home for unwed mothers that her folks put her into.
See. 4 years? That means that...
She was 13 when I met her. But right well developed, let me tell you. Okay, Miss Pris. She came to the derby that I won. You know, after that, you know, I couldn't shake her. Last spring, she, you know, calls me up, tells me, I'm pregnant, Jake. I want to get married. Getting married's what I said, and I hung up. I probably should have handled it differently.
Yeah, you were shocked.
Yeah.
It was a surprise.
A couple months back, and I realized she disappeared. So, I tracked her down. I sent the letter asking if she needed anything sent. I'm not a bad man, right?
Right.
She wrote back saying all she wanted was to get out of there. So I decided to send her some money.
So you robbed the bank?
No. Oh. What do you take me for? I went to see my brother-in-law, Marvel Hodge.
Excuse me.
Marvel? Marvel, can I talk to you a minute?
Excuse me, folks.
Make it quick, Jake.
Okay, look, Marvel, even though you're supposed to be some relation to me, I'm not such a fool as to ask you for a gift or a loan.
Good.
I do need money, but I'm not gonna ask that.
Oh, that is the blessing.
Yeah, all I want is a job, you know, fair and square.
Well, I'd have to have me some peculiar personality to do that. Give Jake Sims a job? Who never was out of trouble since the very first day he was born? A job!
Marvel. Marvel, I may have done one or two hasty things in my time, but I'm a grown man now. I'd like you to reconsider your words, if you please.
Grown? I don't think I'll live to see the day. Now, you leave me with these good people here, son. A job! In-laws. We all have them. We wish we didn't. I got them, too.
It's so rude.
Normally, I see stars when I get angry. I was able to keep my temper. And when I saw him standing right in front of my car, it just happened. All I could see was him laughing at me. I tried to keep my temper in jail, too, but one thing I couldn't stand was for my son to be born in no prison. It tore me up.
So you escaped?
Nothing to it. They watch you less careful on the way to trial. They figure you still got some hope of being cleared. I knew the only hope was to get away. I took the money for the baby, not for me. If it was up to me, I would have just disappeared. I thought I'd clear a couple grand easy.
Anyway, I won't be hanging around long enough to find out.
Oh, God, he's got a gun!
Anybody move and I'll kill it!
I've never been lucky, not one time.
How can you say that? You're nothing but lucky. Well, it was lucky that you grabbed me at the bank instead of the little old lady in front of me, because she never could have kept up. And the guard? You shot that gun right out of his hand. You're gonna tell me that wasn't a lucky shot?
I was aiming for his face.
And it was so lucky that you missed. And really lucky that we got away.
We ain't away yet.
You weren't really trying to hit him in the face, were you? Well, I think maybe shooting someone in the face is kind of rash. You've got to see the bigger picture. My gosh, you're gonna have a child coming. You don't want to miss out on being a part of that. I lost a baby once. A miscarriage. You know, you never know how much you really want something until it's taken away. Maybe you should just visit Mindy and see how she's doing, not just send her random money. I think you're trying to do the right thing.
You talk a good game, lady. I'll give you that. What is it you want?
I'd really like for you to set me free.
No.
Listen, I know you're scared, but we're way past the roadblocks and everything, and they're looking for a man traveling with the hostage. And I'm not gonna tell anybody, I swear.
Damn it, I said no, and I mean it. You're staying with me.
But I told you I wouldn't.
You want me to shoot you in the face? You want that? I don't want to hear another word about it. Don't make me hurt you, Sean.
Jake Sims is a malcontent. He's a sulky, testy, hot-headed, heavy-footed grumbler, if you'll pardon my French. You ask me if he'll harm the hostage? Yes.
Jake Sims, kai lao ya ka pasi. Lu kwa, wa kai lang hoi ne jimi kya lima. I hoa 4%, 8%, lu an zha xiong ho.
Calm down. Calm down.
Oh. It's neat.
Let's get out of here. Come on. Come on. Come on. God damn it! All hell. Jesus, this rotten piece of shit. Motor quit.
Maybe it's just out of gas.
No.
That's it. It's out of gas. So what do we do now? Did you see a gas station any place? Or I don't know, farmhouse that might have some...
You'd think people would fill their gas tanks every once in a while. You'd think.
Maybe they just didn't know how long you'd be stealing it for.
Watch it, lady. Just watch it. God, everything's just closing in on me. Okay. I'm gonna do what I say. You're gonna steer the car. I'm gonna push her to the side of the road.
Oh, no. No, excuse me. Excuse me.
What?
I don't know how to drive.
What kind of a person doesn't know how to drive?
I don't know.
No, all I said, you're gonna steer the car. You're gonna move over. You're gonna steer the fucking car.
But I don't. Okay. How am I doing so far?
Turn around!
Ah!
Jesus.
Oh, that was a mistake.
Totally unbelievable.
I'm really sorry. It was my fault. Gosh. It's just it'll go. Okay.
Finished?
Yeah.
Let's go.
What? I need. Oh, my purse.
Leave it.
Oh. My feet are gonna drop off. My toes are aching up to my knees. Can't I walk by myself? But where am I gonna run to, anyhow?
Won't make sense that you can't drive.
As if that's to blame for all of our troubles.
Why can't you?
Look.
I'd like to know.
Some people drive, some people don't. My husband never taught me.
Anyone can drive.
What?
Charlotte, anyone can drive if you just take time to learn.
But you know I can't.
I don't have time to drive you, Charlotte. I'm working on tomorrow's sermon.
Oh, please, Zach.
Sweetheart, it's not my fault if you can't drive.
Oh, and I suppose it's my fault that they moved the Walmart to Hudson Street. Come on, I just asked you to do one little thing. You go out all the time. Huh? You go out to mutter your scripture or practicing handshakes, whatever it is that you do. It's not fair. Don't look at me like that. It's not my fault I'm not religious. And it's a lot harder to be good, you know, without religion. You should give me an A for effort.
I can't drive you anywhere right now.
Oh, Zach, don't you get tired of us straining at each other so all the time? Aren't you ever worried that you might come home one day and I'd be gone? For good. Forever?
You would never leave me.
What?
Charlotte, I know you love me. I know you do.
Shouldn't you be saying that you love me?
I am, Charlotte. I am. You're not paying attention.
You're not paying attention. You're gonna ask the guy for a can of gas. You got that?
Why do I have to ask him? Hello.
What can I do you for?
We need gas in a can because our car.
Fine. Just relax.
Okay.
I'll be right back.
Scrub and. Mercury Sable.
Oh,
police are concerned about a woman hostage who has been identified as Mrs. Charlotte Emery.
Oh. That he could have given them.
Covering the story from our sister station, WKZN, is Heidi Anderson, who filed this report.
There is conflicting information as to whether Charlotte Emery is a hostage or a suspect in the Clarion bank robbery.
What?
We have with us Amanda Schmidt, who was with her at the bank.
I simply say she knew. She told me she wouldn't be staying in town. But that was before he took her. Now, how would she know that unless she was in on it?
Heidi Anderson is now standing by live with the hostage's husband.
Could this have been a voluntary action on her part?
You don't know Charlotte. She's a good woman. I'm certain she'll be back.
If you could, is there anything you'd like to say to her?
You think she's watching TV? She's been abducted.
That's your husband?
That appears to be all we have now, Stu. Back to you at the studio.
How long have you been watching?
Well, I've been watching 30 years. Matter of fact, I'm thinking of color. But I don't know. $2 even. You return the can, right?
Right. Thank you.
Thank you.
I thought you were running out on.
I was.
How come he said that then?
Oh, because he knows that every other time I've tried to leave him, I've never gotten farther than the bank before I've chickened out. And so he's always saying things like that. You'll never leave me, Charlotte. It really gets my goat. I wish you could see me now, huh? I mean, I'd send him a postcard and say, so long, sucker, moving on, at last, having a wonderful time. And then I'd mail it from Tahiti or Las Vegas or something.
Just calm down.
And did you see the picture that he chose? I mean, of all the pictures he could have given, I mean, it's a great picture of him, of course, but what about me? I mean, it's like he's already forgotten what I look like.
Don't even think about trying something, all right? Nice and easy.
Trouble?
Our car ran out of gas. We're just walking back to it now.
Uh-huh. Oh, hop in.
Thanks.
Thanks for the lift.
You're welcome.
Yes, thank you.
It's gonna be the safe place. One of just left. There's a lot up there.
I want to thank you for the lift, officer. You know, we'd be walking all day without you.
Well, no problem. Where are you folks from?
California. Hollywood.
No kidding. So, you and your mama out here visiting?
Mama? Yeah. Yeah, we're just, you know, traveling, taking some time off, you know.
That's nice. You work there, ma'am? Ma'am?
Mom? Mom?
I have a pension.
It was nice visiting with you folks.
Yeah.
Oh, boy, that's some color you got on your car there.
Yeah, it is, huh? Well, thank you. Thanks, officer. All right.
Have a good day.
I want to thank you.
I don't want to talk about it.
All right?
Certainly. Why do you ask?
I'm sorry you thought you were my mama. What could I do? The fact of the matter is I'm obliged to you for keeping quiet for once, Charlotte. You ought to be glad you're out of it. It's one thing. Away from that preacher husband, that cruddy house.
I grew up in that cruddy house.
Couldn't keep me shut up in no boring place any more than prison. Any day now, you're gonna thank me is the way I look at it. Holy shit!
Get out of the car, put your hands in the air. Release the hostage. Now!
You can just...
just let me off anywhere. That was sort of fun. Go that way.
Where's my... Where's my gun? Got here, Charlotte, take the wheel.
Oh, no.
Charlotte, come on. Come on. Whoa. Enjoying your trip?
Yeah. If I'd known it was this much fun, I would have done it a long time ago.
Okay. Okay. Good driving, Charlotte.
Whoops. Careful, you're getting too close.
Look, what, you telling me how to drive now? Come on, hurry up. Just let me pass. What?
Maybe you should just honk at them, huh?
Look, the person in the driver's seat honks the horn. Come on!
Damn. Oh. Let's make sure they're okay.
All right.
Jesus. You'd be nice now. Are you all right?
He's a menace. I've been telling him that for years. He has no business driving. A menace! His license expired years ago. Only I'm not supposed to tell anyone. Let me drive, I say. But no, he won't hear of it.
Actually, if it's anybody's fault, it's probably ours because we were in a hurry and we got a little impatient.
Don't be nice to him. He'll only get encouraged.
It's a pretty old jalopy. How's she fixed?
She's a pile of junk is what she is. A pokey old dinosaur. If I said it once, I said it 100 times.
Do you want to trade? The fact is, we need this here car, folks.
Jake?
Now, our automobile is twice the machinery as yours, and you know that. We're going to take a loss on the trade for any inconvenience.
You're taking our car?
Well, I'm upgrading you. Come here, I'll help you out of the car, sir.
There's a tiny little problem with the front right light. I'm sorry.
Why, this is a carjacking. That's what it is. I'll call the police.
Excuse me. Look, okay, you call the police, and I'm going to have to hunt you down and kill you. And you don't want that now, do you? No. Okay, so I'm going to help you out of the car now, all right? Okay, just come with me. Take it easy, nice and easy. Got it?
Well, Frank, do something. He's threatened me. He's probably a wanted man. Are you just going to let him get away? Frank?
Take me with you.
I wonder how long they've been married.
Who knows? There's a hell of a lot of miles on this car.
Where are we going, anyway?
Well, now you ask me, huh?
Are we going to see your girl?
No. I'm not like you, Sean. Anyway, she's gonna give the kid up for adoption. I don't think Mindy would make such a hot mother anyway.
Still, even if you give the baby away, maybe it'd be good to take care of Mindy a little bit, get her in a better place. You did rob a bank for her.
Jesus, Charlotte, come on. We're on the run here. I mean, I don't have time to walk us over to Lynneth to go running after Mindy. We're going to Perth. That's South Carolina.
Lynneth, Perth, you sound like you're lisping.
What?
Skip it.
We're going to see my friend Scotty. When I was a kid, if I got into trouble, Scotty, he'd always figure a way out. He was a wild one. He was always there when I needed him. Okay?
I can't wait to meet Scotty.
Shit.
What's that?
I don't believe it.
It's smoke. There's smoke.
Yeah,
excuse
I noticed.
Me.
Man.
I can't breathe. There's definitely a problem.
Damn it. Let's go. Jeez.
Oh, I love this place. I feel great. I haven't been hiking in years.
I don't think they're on to us, Charlotte. You can slow down.
What's the matter, Sonny? You can't keep up with your mama?
You're not old enough to be my mama.
Aha! Don't bet on it.
Yeah, you couldn't have kids my age.
Well, how old do you think I am?
31.
You are so new. Anyway, it doesn't matter. It's just a number. It doesn't mean anything.
That's what I say, honey.
Whoa. Wow. I never held one of these before.
Yeah, well, you can give it back now.
Well, how's it look? What do you think? You like me with it? Does it make me look fat? Do you trust me with it?
Yeah, I trust you.
Okay, then you can have it back again, honey. Wow. Oh, this place is beautiful. What a great day. Look at this view.
How come you married that Frankenstein husband of yours anyway?
It's not a Frankenstein.
I got a good look at him on television. You could have done way better. You love him?
Of course.
How'd you hook up with him?
My husband was the boy next door. Or literally, the boy next door. One day he just up and left, and when he came back, he was full of stories of where he'd been and what he'd done tomcatting around.
The preacher?
Oh, he wasn't a preacher then. He didn't get the calling till after we were married. He was different then. He'd write long romantic poems and notes and hide them in my pocket, put them in my books. Only he'd sign them Richard Nixon or Fred Mertz.
So panteth my soul after thee.
I used to go to church on Sundays, and I'd watch his hands gripping the pulpit during sermons. The entire congregation was glued to his every word while I was bored out of my mind. And I think to myself, who is this man?
My tears have been my meat day and night. Though thou hast sore broken us in the place of dragons and covered us with...
Once he became a minister, Zach was against making love on Sundays. I was in favor of it, so I'd plot how to get him into bed.
Our heart is not turned back. Neither have our steps declined from thy way. Almighty Lord, watch over you and bless you. In Jesus' name, amen. Everyone, please rise.
When Zach wanted to make love, he'd do the strangest thing. He'd place his hand up against mine, palm to palm.
Like this?
Yeah.
How old were you when you married him?
19. He called up so much love in me. I thought that he would rescue me and get me out of my mother's house, but then he moved in. I was stuck there. Oh, gosh, I...
Come on, Charlotte.
They ran us off the road and stole our car. Well, she's just as pluggy and pert as you please. But he's an evil, mean, honey-tongued hoodlum.
I liked him.
They were friendly. They were sweet. Dare I say it, attractive individuals. But beware the sheep in wolf's clothing. Wolf in sheep's clothing.
Brand new car, no keys. All the lights are off, so I think we're safe.
Okay.
I'm gonna go up, ring the bell, make sure nobody's home.
What? I'm gonna ring the bell. Why do I have to ring the bell?
I'm asking you, just go ring the bell.
What am I gonna say if there's somebody comes to the door?
I don't know. Say you're a Jehovah's Witness or something.
I don't have any pamphlets.
No, shut. Shopping. Go to the other bedroom and look.
Okay.
Hurry up.
Oh my gosh, this is my very same bed spread the wall.
Check the other bedroom.
Okay, all right.
We don't have time for this.
My gosh, it's close every place. It's a pigsty. This is so creepy. I don't know why I have to change my look. I didn't rob a bank.
Just put anything on.
I am putting anything on. Oh gosh, this is too tight. I can't see what I'm doing. Oh, it's fuzzy. Now, where do my shoes go?
Bingo!
Yes!
What?
Guess I am lucky.
I knew that.
Take the boots.
Really?
Yeah.
Please, Jake, I'm starving. Can't we stop?
All right, all right. Here's the place. Doesn't look like we'll run into anybody here.
Oh, I feel ridiculous.
What are you talking about? You look great. Stars.
Well, you see, it's a rule. You take one and you stick it on your face for every drink you have, and then folks know if you're okay to drive home.
Well, that's very clever.
Well, you know, we think so too. Now, what can I get you?
Oh, no, thank you. I don't really drink.
They're very fruity. Very fruity. We have a little game here. You close your eyes and you just pick one. Come on. Come on, dude. Come on.
Charlotte.
Go for it. Come on.
Pink panties?
Boys love that. Come on. Your turn.
No, I'm okay, oh, thanks.
Go ahead, it's your turn.
No, I don't.
It's gonna hurt you. Come on.
Melon balls.
Oh, melon balls.
Melon balls.
Yeah.
She scares me.
One more and you're gonna look like an American flag.
Yeah, six is my limit.
Mm. Come on, these are so watered down. I mean, they only count as three.
Really?
Yeah.
Is that true?
Mm.
Ruth Ann.
Hang on.
Hey there. You know, I've been watching you secretly from across the room all night.
Really? I saw you.
Cut a rug with an old man. You make me very happy.
Oh, thank you so much, but I don't know how to dance.
Well, what you doing in a dance hall?
Hiding out.
sure you won't change your mind.
I'm sure.
Don't know what you're missing.
Well, neither do you. Oh, my.
Charlotte?
Uh-huh?
Will you dance with me?
I just said no to him, Jake. I can't.
Well, you better say yes. Because, I'm just going to keep on asking.
Well, you are the guy with the gun.
Who's that?
I'll put him on the table.
When I was younger, my sister, we were growing up, she was shy, and if she didn't get invited to a party, you know, I'd put on a record and we'd dance around the room and to cheer her up.
Aww. Your sister was so lucky to have you. I bet you're really close.
No, I haven't seen her in a while. She got married, moved away.
Oh. Well, you're a really wonderful dancer.
I got loose, I haven't even shown you yet. Charlotte. Maybe we should just get married so we could tell people how we met.
Oh, girl. I thought you said you didn't know how to dance.
Well, he just taught me. You leave her alone, Henry. You're all mine tonight. I know it's a bed, but didn't we ask for a double?
That is a double.
No, double means two.
No.
Yeah.
Well, that's big enough for two.
It used to mean two. I'm gonna go wash up.
Okay.
Okay.
All right.
I'm not thinking what you're thinking.
You want me to get naked?
No, I don't. No.
Come on, Charlotte. Don't you get tired of being such a good girl? What?
Nothing.
Are you laughing at me?
No.
It's being a good girl. I mean, does that line really work for you? In case you haven't noticed, I'm not, you know, 13-year-old girl. I was just...
No, I noticed, all right. I was asking you because I felt sorry for you. Fact is, you give me the creeps, lady.
Jake.
Don't fool me. You allow yourself to get led around by the nose, because if somebody else is doing the leading, you're not to blame. I'm so on to you, lady, it's not even funny.
Is that really the way you see me?
I've never seen someone so scared in all my life. Let's just forget about it, okay? It was another damn impulse. Why don't you just leave, Charlotte?
Why don't you just leave, Jake?
Because I paid for this room.
Well, you used my money. And why would I want to get mixed up with some macho, half-grown, nail-biting jailbird anyway, myself? I mean, okay, maybe I am scared, but at least I don't call it an impulse. You're so terrified of everything that you just run towards nothing all the time.
I'm not one of your kids, lady, so don't lecture me.
Oh, I don't have any kids.
What? You said...
I know what I said. I lied. After I had a miscarriage, I couldn't have any children.
I thought you weren't the type to lie.
I lie to myself sometimes. I pretend that I have kids, and I imagine what they'd be like. I've never told that to anybody before.
I didn't mean those things I said.
I know.
So come here.
Why should I?
I want to dance.
He was adorable, very smiley and chatty-like, and he wasn't a gangster. He was a puppy. Though they were drunk. Must have had about 12 stars between them.
Well, but I mean, dancing with a hostage, I mean, what does that say?
They broke into our house and took our favorite things. My brother's brand new Jeep and my new outfit. My brother can, like, replace his car, but I got that top and skirt from last season's catalog. I hope they catch them, lock them up, and they get abused in prison.
Is Charlotte Emery Clarion's own Patty Hearst, or is she an unwitting pawn in the hands of a petty criminal? The preacher's wife and the thief. How will it play out? Find out tonight at 11 on News Now.
How about that place? It looks sweet.
I ain't going to no bar called Chris's.
I don't see why not. Look, it's the hottest spot in town, the sign says.
Yeah, take a look at the town.
He makes me stay when I don't want to stay.
Charlotte, want a soda or something?
No, just the key of the ladies.
Jesus. It's him, isn't it? It's the bank robber from Clarion. You know, your husband's been all over the news looking for you. I wasn't sure it was him till he called you Charlotte. Are you okay, lady?
Yeah.
Well, go inside and call the police. I'll hold him. Go on, hurry up.
Hello?
Zach?
Charlotte? Is that you?
Yeah. Don't you recognize my voice?
Well, I haven't seen you around the house lately. What's new?
Charlotte, where are you?
I don't know.
You don't know?
Oh, I know what you're thinking. Charlotte's calling from somewhere, and there's probably a sign right in front of her.
Now, he hasn't hurt you, has he? I mean, you're not...
Oh, no. No, heaven's sakes, no. Oh, no, it's not like that. You don't have to worry.
I know you'll be back. I'm not worried.
You're not?
Would you rather I was worried?
Maybe I won't be back. Maybe you will never see me again. Did that ever occur to you?
Get a hold of yourself.
I'm calm as a fish.
Come on, lady, hurry up.
What's going on there?
Hey. I can't talk anymore. I'm in the middle of another hostage situation. I've got to go.
Sharp.
Jeez, lady, where the hell you been? Did you call the police? Are they on their way?
No, they're on the phone. I didn't know where we were, so they want to talk to you, and I'll watch him.
Jeez, be careful where you're pointing that thing. Well, you just shoot him if he tries anything. Just shoot him.
I want to thank you for picking me at the bank. But you better go now. I want you to go.
Hello. Hello. Hello.
The floor will have its way, it seems. It fights me like a trampoline. It won't let me on the ground. And this time I'm not coming down. This time I'm not coming down.
I see you have a job around here. Chrissy? Is that you? Would you be Chrissy?
Lady, you don't want to work here.
Oh, sure I do. I think it's great. It's dark. It's secluded. I bet nobody I know would be coming in here.
You want a drink?
Yeah. Yeah. I don't suppose you have anything that's fruity, do you? Okay, how about tequila? A shot of tequila? Hi. Thank you.
$1.
Oh. Chrissy, you're not going to believe this, but I gave my money away. I have... I might have a single bill or something in here somewhere. It's only... I have coupons. I have lipstick. I have... Oh, my God. You're not going to believe this. In my secret compartment all this time, I have my travel money. It's been in there so long, I completely forgot about it. Here, look, there.
We don't take checks.
Only cash.
I know, but this is as good as cash. See, it's a traveler's check for $100.
Eddie!
I can't. All this time I've been in here, and
she orders a drink, and then tells me she has no money.
Eddie, I have a traveler's check.
We don't take checks.
Okay, well, I just didn't know that. I'm really sorry. I mean, I've been walking half the day. I just wanted a little... Okay, forget about it. You keep the drink. It's a dollar. You keep it. You can have it back, all right?
She already drank some.
I took a little sip.
What is this?
Come with me, baby. Oh, I'm so sorry. I did... Eddie, just...
Charlotte.
Jake.
I've been looking all over for you.
Hey, we're in the middle of something here.
Oh, yeah? What's going on?
I couldn't pay for my drink.
Oh, gosh. I had your money. I didn't tell you. Let me pay for it.
Oh! Oh, my God! Oh! Oh!
Oh! Easy on the bar.
Oh!
Anybody else got a problem with me, huh?
Well, actually, she was kind of mean to me, too.
Yeah?
Jake, stop it! Stop it! Please, stop! Stop, you're gonna kill him!
Get up!
Stop it! Stop! You're killing him! Stop!
Eddie, you okay?
What the hell were you doing in there?
Protecting you.
Oh, don't kill anybody on my account.
That's an ungrateful fucking attitude.
You were completely out of control. I mean, you say, let me think, but you don't think, Jake. I mean, you could have killed that man.
Get in the car. Please knock that off.
I don't want you to go to jail. End up dead. I don't want you ever to lose control like that again. I think you're better than that.
Here we are. Look at this place. Gives me the creeps.
So now what?
We'll give her the money, maybe lift somewhere, and get the hell out of here.
Oh, Jake, look at this view.
Charlotte, let me get on with this, please.
It's kind of early to call, isn't it?
I'll dial, you talk.
Why do I have to talk?
Well, you think they're gonna let a man through?
Seems a little late for that.
Okay, just ask for Mindy. Okay, tell her you're her aunt or something.
Hello?
Good morning. May I speak to Mindy, please?
What's going?
This is her aunt, Mindy Kylander.
Hi, it's me. What? Yeah. Well, who else would be calling? We're out front. Look, Mindy, we're in a hurry here, okay? So if we're gonna get you out of there, you gotta be quick. We don't have time. Okay. Okay. Yeah. She wants to take the Rovers out first. 5 more minutes, I'll wait, and then we're out of here.
Is that her?
Yeah, that's her. She's big. She's riding with me. For a while.
She married?
Of course she's married. Let her alone.
I'm just asking.
She's riding with me to South Carolina. She's paying at the expense.
South Carolina? Oh my God, Jake, is that where we're headed? Oh my God.
Whoa. Slow down a minute, Mindy. Slow down.
Mindy Callender, where are you off to at this hour?
Oh shit, quick.
Mindy!
Get in. Oh.
Hi, I'm Mindy Callender.
Hi, Charlotte Emery.
Did you notice how big my boobs have gotten?
Well, look, Mindy, now that we busted you out, have you thought about where you want to...
Oh, I have this really great gum. Here. If you chew it, then the car will smell like perfume.
They let you keep money in that place?
Well, I'm sure. Like, if we wanted to walk into town or something, buy a soda or shampoo.
Well, let me get this straight. You can just walk into town any old time you want.
What's wrong with that? You know, just last week, Miss Bohannon had us walk into town and buy 3 books on childcare.
Childcare?
It teaches you how to care for a child, silly.
No. I mean, I thought most of the girls, you know, put their kids up for adoption.
Oh, sure, but they're not the ones taking the course. I mean, those girls take good grooming.
So what are you telling me? You keeping this baby?
Well, naturally. Are you saying we should just...
We?
Of course we. God, otherwise why would you just come all this way for murder? Oh my God! Oh my God, murder! Oh my
God!
Pull over!
What's going on?
Oh my God! I can't believe I forgot! Stop!
I'm stopping. What the hell is murder?
Murder! Oh my God, murder!
You didn't think I'd just leave you zipped up in there?
Oh my poor kitty.
What the hell is that?
It's therapeutic. Miss Bohannon at the home says so.
You got cats there? I mean, get my baby out of prison. That's what you said. That's some prison. You lied to me, Mindy.
It wasn't a lie, okay? How could you say that? Anyways, it doesn't make any difference. We're together now.
Whoa, wait a minute.
Jake, we're gonna get married and have a home and the prettiest little baby you ever saw.
A home?
You know, Charlotte, I was thinking of making the house really summery. Lots of those white curtains with the black tie backs. What are those called?
Priscilla's.
Priscilla's, that's what we're gonna have, Priscilla's. Mm. You know, everything everywhere but in the living room, because there we should have fiberglass drapes, gold, you know, maybe avocado. What do you think? Oh my God, Barn Village, that place is the best. We have to go there. Can I drive, Jake, you know, because of my foot cramps? Thank you. Come on, you guys! I love this.
Take much more, Charlotte.
All right, Jake.
Just jabbering away. Cat puking in the car every 5 minutes.
It's not her fault the cat's sick.
Well, it's her fault the cat's here. At this rate, we're never gonna make Scotty's. Maybe we should just leave without her.
Jake! She loves you, and she's having your baby.
Look at her. She's just hobbling around, like...
Well, she's got foot cramps.
Well, that's not my fault.
Yes, it is. All right, all right. I will get her to hurry along.
Get her to shut up.
Mindy.
Hey, I've been thinking and...
Charlotte, can you just explain to him? It was not a lie. He just doesn't understand.
Doesn't understand what?
Well, Miss Bohannon's place, it really is a prison if you've got no place else to go, isn't it?
I think he was just surprised is all.
He bites my head off. I mean, I panic. I really do try and tell him, but all I end up talking about are curtains.
Well, you just have to know how to talk to him is all.
I think I know him better than you do. I know you like him too, Charlotte. I'm not such a dope as you think I am. I've seen it right off. Ain't your fault, I guess. He is pretty cute. But what am I supposed to do?
Maybe we should just have a little quiet time in the car. You know, it's been a long trip. Everybody's kind of tense.
You're gonna cause trouble for me, Charlotte.
We better get going.
For no parade.
Please, Jake.
You really have fun. Take it easy. Scotty.
Oh, look at you.
You shouldn't be here, Jake. You know the cops are hunting you?
Cops? What cops?
They came by yesterday. They told me you pulled this crazy with... But you didn't, did you?
I don't know. Sort of.
What would make you rob a bank for that piddling amount? And a hostage? You'd take a... Who's a hostage here and who isn't?
Hostage.
Lord, Jake, it was nothing that I planned, okay? It just worked out this way. Impulse, you know? Can't you give us a room? We'll sit down and we'll figure a way out of this, please. I'd like to help you, Jake, but they're watching me too. I'm on parole. And Claire.
Claire?
Yeah, that's my wife. She's got her hands full with the baby. Besides, why don't just call the police? Maybe you don't think about giving yourself up.
No.
No one!
What happened to you?
Think about it.
Lots of luck.
Scotty! Scotty!
Maybe... Can you at least take Mindy?
I'm sorry, Jake. Sorry.
I heard that. What do you mean, take Mindy? You robbed a bank? I could have had our baby in jail and all for something I never had the faintest notion of? How could you not tell me? And you? I'm a hostage.
Anyone would have guessed, Mindy. We never hit one highway. I mean, what do you think we traveled all those dusty, bumpy back roads for?
For the derby, of course.
This is clearly no fucking derby.
Hey, don't swear at her.
Oh, great, Charlotte. Take her part. Take her part while I'm so low.
Jay. So what kind of hostage are you?
What?
Bastard. Come on, come on.
Oh, no. Maya! Maya,
sure you left the window open, Charlotte.
I'm sorry.
He would have died anyway if we shut the window.
Are you
it's
sure?
Not Charlotte's fault.
He's How gone. Murder. He's gone. He's gone.
What?
Murder.
Are you sure? Well,
Mindy, we don't have time for that. We gotta go.
Mindy.
Mindy. Is. I'm not going
Mindy,
without him.
You gotta stop.
Murder.
Please.
Come here, Murder.
To me.
Mindy.
Murder.
Mindy. Mindy, we gotta go.
If I have to, Jake Sims, I can do this all by myself. I love you, Jake. To my mind, you'll always be like the first time I met you, but I have this baby now to take care of, and from now on, I'm not listening to any more of your promises.
I didn't make no promises.
Let me just ask yourself what you told me last 4th of July.
What'd you tell her?
Told me he'd never come to rest with anyone but me. He said he didn't know why, it was just the way he felt. And that's when he asked if I would marry him.
Did?
I didn't. I never did.
Well, you said you could see that it might someday come to pass.
No, I think you got it twisted around to suit yourself.
No, Jake, it's you that twists. Murder! You know, every time you run from me, there's another time you run after me. He drives by my house at night. He calls to my window. Mindy, Mindy, you're all I got. Everybody's mad at me and the world don't look so good. Can't you come out and keep me company?
She just likes to exaggerate.
Listen, what you said was you could see that we might one day find ourselves married.
If I did, I don't recall it.
Like if I got pregnant or something? I'm going to go hunt my cat. You two, you look down that way and be quick about it. Murder!
What you thinking?
Just wondering how all this is gonna turn out.
You drop it, or I'll kill her. I'm telling you, I'll kill her. I don't care anymore. Easy.
There's a path out of here, Charlotte.
I don't want to play anymore.
I won't let nothing happen to you, I promise. I just don't want them deciding on how things are going to turn out. It should be up to us. Please, now, Charlotte. Please. Fine, Charlotte. We need to go forward, though.
Yes, I know that.
gotta get out of here. Let's go, hurry.
Keep running.
Stay here for a while. When it gets dark, we'll take off.
Where next? You can't keep running, Jake.
Why not? You said I was lucky, Charlotte.
No one's luck holds forever.
You bring me my luck.
Happy right when the happiness was going on, but
it's never been a problem
when I've been with you.
What's wrong?
It's time for me to go.
I know, Charlotte. No, I can't manage without you yet. I mean, all this ain't so bad with you here. You're the only one who's ever believed in me.
You'll be fine.
How about we know each other? We really do, don't we?
Yes. Yes.
So why are you doing this?
I'm sorry. It's just... it isn't me. Tell Mindy goodbye for me.
Listen to me, I don't even know what I'm talking about. You can't leave, okay? I mean, you gotta travel. How are you gonna do that? Just tell me that.
I'll go to the police and I'll tell them that I escaped.
You're a part of this now. I mean, they're not gonna believe you're a hostage, Charlotte. Besides, what? Where are you gonna go? Huh? Are you gonna go back? Everything you ran from? Your little house? Your husband? Don't make me hurt you.
You keep moving and I'll shoot! Keep going, Charlotte. I'm gonna shoot you! What are you doing? Come back!
I'm aiming now.
It's pointed at your heart. You hear what I'm saying? Don't make me do this! Charlotte! Charlotte!
Charlotte.
Mm-hmm.
Letter.
You ready?
Still up for this?
Of course, aren't you?
Sure. Just let me get my coat.
Dear Charlotte. Well, did you really think you heard the last of me? I'm living in Mexico now. Yep. Learning Spanish, if you can believe it. In a pretty fancy hotel that waters down their drinks something fierce. I hand them out to all the rich, unhappy customers I come across. A cabana boy is what it's called. It ain't so bad. The dinero's okay, and Mindy fixed our place up real fine. I want to thank you for not turning us in. Sorry I didn't write sooner, but I'm writing now to tell you that Mindy had us a baby girl. We named her Lyneth, after where we first took up again. I don't know why I want you to know that, but I do. Do you ever think of me? I wonder that sometimes.
Take things slow, one step at a time. There's nothing to be nervous about.
Thanks, Zach.
Mirror. Remember, I'm right here next to you.
Well, of course you are.
And, put it into R.
For reverse.
On the gas.
And? Okay, and we're off.
He went to Mexico. They all went.